Ooh wee, it's a cold one today. Crazy because it's like 4 days after I recorded my last vlog where it was like 90 degrees. Now it's like 60 degrees. Fancy that, California. And in this one, I'm going to talk about my Tuono V4's mods. So with that said, let the vloggage begin. V4 Symphony still never gets old. Hi, I'm Chad and welcome to virtual reality. I like to start my vlogs in virtual reality because it is a place where we can go fast. So without further ado, let us go fast. Back to reality. So as I mentioned just a moment ago, I'm going to talk about the modifications that have been done to my Aprilia Tuono V4 1100RR, which ones I made myself, which ones the previous owner made, what value I think they added the bike. Woohoo! Coming a little hot there for the street. And yeah, gonna be a quick one, but figured that, you know, you might be wondering. And if not, I just like to talk about my motorcycle, let's be honest here. But I hope that you do enjoy. So with that said, let's take a little stopperoo and look see over to Bikesy. And there she is. So this is my Aprilia Tuono V4. More specifically, my 2017 Aprilia Tuono V4 1100RR. I purchased this motorcycle used with just about 2,900 miles on it from the original owner, who had done a few modifications himself. I made a few more modifications. They're all pretty minor for the most part, but I'm just gonna go over them, who did which ones, and what impact they've had on the bike to me. Gonna start off with my favorite here, and that is this beautiful Graves exhaust. There's also a tune on this bike that was applied via Open Flash Performance, or the Open Flash Performance tuning tablet. The bike runs great. It sounds incredible. I'd swear the microphone, what you're hearing on YouTube, does not do it justice at all. It sounds incredible in real life. It has so much presence, literally shakes the ground beneath it. It's amazing. So in addition to that, there's that map that's on the bike. Works with all the different engine maps that the bike has, so you still get the sport, the track, and the race throttle maps or engine maps, and it feels awesome. The tune has great throttle response. I've heard that these bikes have awesome throttle response stock anyways, but this is the best responding throttle I have ever used on a motorcycle personally, so I'm super happy with it. Again, sounds amazing, especially when you're using the quick shifter. The way, I don't know, again, I think the stock tune does this too, but cuts the ignition kind of hard to try to smooth out the shift at low load, low RPM, but it sounds amazing with the exhaust. Same goes for the blipper as well. So the exhaust and the flash were applied by the previous owner and were definitely an influencing factor in my purchase of this motorcycle, having that I didn't have to do these things myself, and they are certainly the most expensive modifications made to this bike. But yeah, I'm gonna say that's probably my favorite modification out of the lot. Next back here, you can see we have this fender eliminator kit, which looks pretty awesome. Much better than the ugly stock fender. Cleans up the look of the rear end of the bike. I'm happy with it. It's legal as far as I know. So yeah, good deal. So the last part that the previous owner had installed were these Pazzo levers. They're adjustable, and you see tons of knockoffs of these on eBay. These are legit Pazzo racing levers. Not sure if you can see that there on the lever, but it is there. I promise they are real. And they feel nice. Definitely a lot better than the Chinese levers that I've used in the past. So happy with them, recommend them. I prefer levers that curve a little bit more, where you grab them with your finger. These don't, but again, they feel pretty good. They came with the bike, so, and they look nice too. So I'm happy with them and don't see myself changing them. So that rounds out the previous owner's modifications. So let's talk a little bit about what I've done. The first mod that I did to this bike, well, the first two mods, I did them at about the same time, were the Tech Spec snakeskin tank grips. I hate sliding around in the seat, and this seat's actually pretty grippy, so it wasn't a huge deal. but I still like to feel a little bit more stable when I'm hugging the tank under braking, even just riding around on the street. It's a personal preference that I've just gotten used to. So I had to get those. And then this down here is a Woodcraft GP shift lever. Flips the linkage around so it's on top of the shifter. So instead of one down, five up, it's one up, five down. Still works with the factory quick shifter and blipper just as it did before. It's sublime. That was the most impactful modification that I've done because I've been riding with GP shift for pretty much the whole time I've been riding. I think I switched my first bike to GP shift when I've been riding for like 6 months and I've never looked back. First modification I do to every motorcycle that I've bought, it just feels better for me, so I like it. The next modification that I made was the combination of the CRG Aero bar end mirrors, as well as the Rhinomoto bar end slider slash mirror mounts, and the Renthal medium compound superbike grips. Really cleans up the look of the bike. I also bought these little blocking screws to go in place of where the stock mirrors were, just to clean up the look a little bit, make it look a little more complete. Bought those on eBay for like 15 bucks. They're screws that don't do anything. They just sit there and cover up a big hole. I really like the bar end mirrors. They're convex, and so they give you a much better picture of what's around you than the big stock mirrors did. And personally, I think the stock mirrors are kind of ugly, make the scene look kind of like a bug, which some people are about that, just not me personally. I love the CRG Aero mirrors. I think they're very aesthetically pleasing and fit well with the rest of the way that the bike looks, fit into its design language a bit. So another modification that I made to the foot controls of the bike was this little drop peg here. As you can see, there's this little metal bracket that drops down from the stock brake pedal. And this aftermarket, it's actually a Woodcraft peg, but this part is made by AF1 Racing. Go check them out, AF1Racing.com. Not a paid product placement. I just like them and the stuff that they sell. My feet are long and big, and I have long legs too, so my feet sit at a pretty aggressive downward angle on the bike. And the rear brake is not adjustable on this bike stock. The toe peg is eccentric, but there's only so much you can do with it. This adds that additional adjustment, which is perfect for me. Something else probably worth mentioning, and I'm not sure if these were installed by the previous owner or just at the dealer before the bike was sold, but these are actually Aprilia engine case covers. They're a factory or dealer installed option. Again, I'm not sure which, but this bike has them, which is nice because who doesn't like added protection? These here are Dunlop Q3 Plus tires, 120/70/17 front, 190/55/17 rear. The bike had the original Pirelli Diablo Rosso 3 tires. When I purchased it, they were old, so they needed to go. I'm a huge Dunlop fan. I've always purchased Dunlop tires for my motorcycles, and they've never really let me down before. So I figured I would, keep with my habits, and I've been very happy with them. Ridden them on the track, the street, the canyons, and they grip nice. The rear tire is not wearing as hard as the previous generation Q3 or other rear tires that I've used. So very happy with them overall. And the last modification that I have made to the bike, you can't see it here, but why not just look at a pretty Brembo caliper since we're talking about brakes anyways. I changed the brake pads on this. So when I first bought the bike, it had a brake pad recall, and that's just a Brembo issue. So there were Ducatis that had these calipers, Suzukis, multiple bikes by different manufacturers. So again, that's a Brembo issue, not an Aprilia issue. But I got the replacement pads, still wasn't super happy with them. I mean, they work fine, but I also cooked them at the track and one of them got kind of worn out, crooked a little bit. So cleaned up the pistons and seals on my calipers and swapped out for the Ferrato equivalent pad. I'll drop the model number here on the page. I don't remember exactly what they are, but they're the, OE replacement, so the equivalent of the stock Brembo pad. But from what I've read online, they last longer, they grip a little bit better, and they're just a better all-around pad. Got them from AF1Racing.com. Again, this is their pad of choice, so I trusted their recommendation, have been very happy so far. And I'm just kidding, because I've thought of one more thing that I've changed on the bike, and that is the deletion of the EVAP canister right here. Now, this causes issues. It plugs up with fuel over time and can create back pressure in the gas tank, so when you go pop the lid of the tank to put gas in. It can spray some fuel all over the place when the pressure is released. And additionally, it can distort the tank. I've actually felt that before, where the tank kind of expands a little bit because there's no way for all the pressure of that builds up in there when the bike gets hot to really get out through this thing. So remove that. Haven't had any issues since. Cost me like $10 or $15 in parts to do. Just needed a hose, a couple hose connectors, and some tools. But yeah, that covers everything. So with that said, let's ride. Graves exhaust is number one. Quick commentary on the Graves pipe, because I know the Akrapovich pipes are very common on these bikes, as are SC Project pipes. Again, I didn't choose the Graves pipe, the previous owner had put it on, but I love it. I love the way it sounds, I love the way it looks, and I love that it's a little unique. You know, I haven't actually seen anybody else riding one of these with a Graves exhaust, so I like it. Anyways, that is going to do it for this vlog. Go ahead and do me a favor, gently click the like button if you enjoyed this video. Consider subscribing if you want to see more Aprilia Tuono V4 content, as well as Daytona 675R on track content. Got some cool stuff in the works for you. Should be some fun, interesting content. Hit that notification bell if you want to know when it's going to happen. But yeah, until next time, I hope you have a lovely week and rest of your life. Later.